Ladies and gentlemen, announcing the arrival of the Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Lieutenant General Jesse Diaz de Liosa, Armed Forces of the Philippines. He is welcomed by...
Thank you. Thank you. passenger for his stand is first to sing the Philippine National Anthem. and to give command of your inhabitants to account for it. First is the launch. The precise serious position of the brigade staff has select officers from each battalion march forward to receive instructions from the brigade commander. Communication with soldiers and communications must pass through proper channels. This is a practical tool in the military profession that signifies the importance of the chain of command. So the chain of command is more effective than efficient working arrangement results among men of arms. Now, approaching the grandstand, ladies and gentlemen, are the members of the chain of command. The officers of the cadet corps armed forces of the Philippines. Upon the salute of his officers, the brigade commander acknowledges, gives instructions for the regiment to proceed up to the respective posts.
To the Honorable Voltaire T. Gazmin, Secretary of National Defense, our guest of honor and speaker, Lieutenant General Jesse De Liosa, the Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines. To our major service commanders, the Commanding General of the Philippine Army, Commanding General of the Philippine Air Force, Flag Officer in Command of the Philippine Navy, the President of DND-OPA, fellow alumni, friends, visitors, Mrs. Maria Amparo Peralta, my wife, Team PMA, the Cadet Corps, Armed Forces of the Philippines, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Welcome to this year's alumni homecoming. To the Honorable Voltaire T. Gazmin, sir, accept our utmost gratitude for taking time out from your busy schedule, if only to be with us today in this very important occasion. Thank you very much, sir. Our sincerest appreciation also to the overwhelming number of cavaliers right in front of us, who never fail to honor their alma mater with their gracious presence. Reflecting on this momentous occasion, I cannot help but reminisce the time that I spent here in the academy. I could stop at the many pleasant memories from flooding my thoughts, that it almost overwhelms me with a multitude of emotions. At this point, let me share with you what this very important occasion reminds me, and I'm sure all of you can easily identify me. I compare this alumni homecoming to the coming home of a son or a daughter who for a long time has been far away from the place he calls home. As he starts his journey, he experiences a feeling of excitement. This feeling is brought about by the memories of the place where he grew up and learned his very first lessons in life. The moment he arrives at the doorstep, he notices the changes that have happened with the passing of time. he notices the immediate surroundings, the wear and tear that their home have been subject to. And most importantly, he notices the familiar faces in the house, his parents and relatives. He shares his adventures with them, good or bad. He tells them how he faced the challenges he encountered in the field, and how his parents' advice proved to be helpful to him. He also gives advice to the younger brood, the cadet corps, hoping that these will be useful as they try to face life by themselves. And of course, his visit of homecoming would not be complete if he does not enjoy the company of his family and old acquaintances. At the end of his visit, and as he bids them goodbye, he makes sure that everything is in order until his next homecoming. These are the same feelings we experience and do as we have our alumni homecoming today. We see familiar places and faces. We see changes in the places that we once frequented, and we encounter much younger people around us. And as we leave, we resolve to do something for the alma mater that has nurtured us in its bosom during our formative years. At this juncture, let me take this opportunity to thank PMAAI and the host classes for making this important gathering possible. You have done a lot for this institution, especially through the payback scheme. Already, part of your contributions were used in the improvement of the athletic complex, and we count on your benevolence and generosity in supporting other projects in the academy. Let this homecoming, therefore, be a venue for all of us gathered here to renew our commitment to our revered institution, the Philippine Military Academy. And as we break bread amongst the children of the academy, let the values of courage, integrity, and loyalty rekindle our spirits as we tread the path of righteous ways. Welcome home, cavaliers. Welcome to the 2012 Alumni Homecoming. Good morning to everyone.
Rise for the honors to the nation. Voltaire to Gazmin to present the award. He is to be assisted by the chairman of PMAAI, Cavalier Remy T. Tigolo, the president, Cavalier Francisco A. Iano Jr., distinguished, outstanding, and unvarnished service to the country. The Lifetime Achievement Award is presented to Cavalier Cesar P. Pogger, PMA Class of 1952.
outstanding performance as military alumni, PMA Class of 1979. For outstanding accomplishment in alumni affairs, the FNO Yedro, PMA Class of 1980. For outstanding performance as police professional in command and administration, the Cavalier Award is presented to Cavalier Alan L. Purissimo, PMA Class 1981. For outstanding performance as military professional in staff functions, the Cavalier Award is presented to Cavalier Emmanuel T. Bautista, PMA Class 1981. For outstanding performance as police professional in police operation, the Cavalier Award is presented to Cavalier Mario B. Yam, PMA Class of 1983. From PMA Class of 1987. Cavalier Joseph Emilio A. Abaya, PMA Class of 1988. For outstanding performance as military professional in Army operations, Cavalier Award is presented to Cavalier Juvimax R. Uy, PMA Class of 1989. For outstanding performance as military professional in Air Force operation, the Cavalier Award is presented to Cavalier Oliver P. Gazumban, PMA Class of 1998. Given this 18th day of February 2012, the Philippine Military Academy, Fort del Pilar, Baguio City. Signed, Cavalier Ray P. Tigre, Chairman. Cavalier Francisco A. Guyami, President. Cavalier Jose Renan C. Suarez, Chairman Awards Committee. Presentation of the Diamond Medallions to the members of PMA Class of 1952. Thank you.
class of 1987. And I request also the younger ladies of this very branch, the ladies of class of 87. Class of 87, this is not the time to salute first. Just say, go on and let's go forward, honey. Now, soldiers, cadets of the Philippine Military Academy, ladies and gentlemen, in view of the present affairs of the state, our invited guest of honor and speaker, the President of the Republic of the Philippines, cannot be with us in today's ceremony. And instead, he sends one of our own, the graduate of the Philippine Military Academy, man of honor and military integrity, a warrior for peace and stability, and a warrior for all battlefronts. My fellow alumni, ladies and gentlemen, it is the message in the messenger that counts. It is therefore my distinct honor and privilege to introduce the most trusted man of all times, the Secretary of National Defense, Secretary Voltaire, Tuvera, Gazmin.
The Superintendent of the Philippine Military Academy, Major General Nonato Peralta Jr., the outgoing and the newly installed directors of the Philippine Military Academy, Alumni Association Incorporated, the Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines, General Jesse Villosa, the Major Service Commanders, the Chief PNP, the Commandant, Philippine Coast Guard, the awardees, jubilarians, my fellow cavaliers, our oldest cavalier present, Cavalier Calvo, our youngest, Cavalier Marquez. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is a great pleasure to be with you today. On behalf of the President of the Philippines, the Commander-in-Chief of our Armed Forces, allow me to share with you his message on this occasion. When this administration assumed office in July of 2010, it did so with the pledge of reclaiming the ideals of transparency, good governance, and accountability in public service, ideals that for so long have been absent in a government burdened with corruption, draft, and impunity. Guided by these ideas, we immediately began to implement reforms and formulate solutions to address the serious problems that cast doubt on the professional integrity and capability of our defense and our military, among others. Today, I am proud to tell you of our concrete achievements in bringing the values of good governance to the military. Before I go on, allow me to thank you for the role that many of you have played in this. We have negated serious malpractices in our bureaucracy. Computerization has allowed us to be transparent about the state of our financial resources, and we have strictly complied with all legal and auditing requirements in our procurement process. None of us here today want to relieve the scandal of graft and corruption that rocked our military over the years. But the success we have had so far only means that much work remains to be done. There are still some who refuse to join us in this reform. Our FIGAO administrator, Cavalier Carolina, has been hard at work in leading the agency of fixers and other unscrupulous individuals who heartlessly victimize our veterans. As a consequence, he has apparently been the subject of a retaliatory harassment case filed against him by the employee against whom he has filed an extortion case. I wish to assure Cavalier Carolina that he has my support in all his efforts to rid our FIBA of undesirable elements who choose to prey on our veterans instead of honoring and respecting them. I know that what is good and just will triumph. These are hurdles we can surpass easily so long as we remain committed to our mandate. We know only too well that strengthening our institutions entails paying special attention to the people to keep them running, in this case, our soldiers. We also know that neither money nor medals and honors can serve as fitting compensation for the sacrifice that those in the armed forces make. They who spend the days and nights protecting the Philippine people at the risk of their own lives. The least that government can do is to show its gratitude by making sure that they have the means to live dignified lives. To boost the morale of our military personnel engaged in combat, we have increased their combat pay by authorizing them the payment of a combat allowance, which gives them an additional 260 a month. We have also a housing program that addresses the housing needs for soldiers and policemen. We initiated this with the construction of 21,800 units at affordable cost in northern and central zone. This was done with the goal of ensuring that our soldiers and policemen will have decent, affordable housing not only in Luzon, but also in Visayas and Mindanao in the future. As regards our internal security endeavors, our armed forces is in the midst of a whole-of-nation approach to win the peace for our country and our people. While we are pursuing lawless elements and ensuring peace throughout our country, we are guided by the principle of justice. We will not tolerate any abuse of power, especially that which culminates in reckless violence, because we foster the utmost respect for human rights and the rule of law. Allow me now to proceed to the main subject of our operational concerns, our endeavors in external security. Paying careful attention to the welfare of our soldiers is not limited to ensuring their well-being outside of the armed forces, in their own home. We also want them to be able to carry out their duties to the best of their ability. RA 7898, or the AFP Modernization Act, was signed in December 1996. This was closely tied to the need to maintain our territorial integrity, to uphold and safeguard the sovereignty of our nation. In December of 2011, the AFP Modernization Act ran the full length of its implementing period and expired without significant progress being made in its agenda. Of the 331 billion meant to be allotted to the AFP Modernization Program, only 35 billion was released to the AFP after 15 years. And this amount was used for the capability upgrade program of the AFP for internal security operations. But in the first 18 months of our administration alone, 16.927 billion was made available for the express purpose of modernizing the AFP. Of this amount, 18 projects worth 4.34 billion have been completed, including the acquisition of the BRP Baguio del Pilar, the Philippines' first honeycomb class asset. The good news is we can expect more of these kinds of equipment and vehicles in the coming year. We are waiting for the full delivery of 8 brand new combat utility helicopters for use by the Philippine Air Force. The first batch of 4 were delivered this week. Our other projects include the acquisition of force protection, coastwise requirements, engineering and utility tracks, and various equipment that will enhance the capability of our soldiers in the field.